Hello students, I welcome you all to our today's class and I am going to explain a new topic that is the chemical properties of carbonyl compounds. So I told you already what is a chemical property. So chemical property, that means here carbonyl compounds reacts with a new reactant to produce our desirable products. Okay, so in this we are having three types of reactions. That means carbonyl compounds mainly undergoes three types of chemical properties or chemical reactions. The first one is base catalyzed reaction. And second one is nucleophilic addition reaction. And third one is nucleophilic addition reaction, which is followed by the removal of water. Okay, so in today's class, I'm going to explain that base catalyzed reaction. So that means here, base acts as a catalyst. That means base can fastens or reduces the rate of reaction. Okay, so in base catalyzed reactions, we'll get different named reactions. Among them, first one is aldol condensation. Okay, that means let us see the definition or the reaction of aldol condensation. Here, two molecules of acetaldehyde undergoes condensation in the presence of sodium hydroxide. Here we can observe sodium hydroxide, which is a base which acts as a catalyst to form aldol. Okay, here aldol means a compound which consists of two functional groups. One is aldehyde and other one is alcohol. So that is the name indicates aldol. Okay, so let us see this reaction now. So acetaldehyde, I'm taking two molecules and these two acetaldehydes condensed in the presence of sodium hydroxide and producing a new compound, that is aldol. This aldol is also called as 3-hydroxybutanol. Okay, 3-hydroxybutanol. Okay, so let us see the mechanism of the reaction. Firstly, I'm taking the sodium hydroxide. This sodium hydroxide, we know, can dissociate into Na plus and OH minus. So when you're adding base to water, it gives OH minus ions. So this OH minus ions in the first step abstracts a proton from the carbonyl compound, that means aldehyde. From acetaldehyde, it is abstracting a proton from the alpha carbon. So alpha carbon means the carbon which is present beside the functional group. You can see here CHO is a functional group. Here CH3 is a alpha carbon. So it is abstracting a proton from the alpha carbon. So when it is abstracting the proton, H2O will be liberated out. OH minus abstracts a proton and liberated out as a H2O. And this, when I'm shifting this bond to this side, this hydrogen gets the positive charge, this CH2 gets the negative charge. So in this first step, carbanion is generated. Okay. Now let us see the second step of aldol condensation mechanism. So in this, we know already carbanion generated in the first step. Okay. I'm taking the same carbanion and I'm attacking on the second molecule of acetaldehyde. So in the first step, we have taken one molecule and second step, I'm taking the second molecule of acetaldehyde. So here, I am taking this acetaldehyde and I'm shifting this bond towards the oxygen. So you can observe this carbonyl group. I am shifting the bond towards oxygen. Oxygen gets a negative charge. Carbon gets a positive charge. So now this positively charged carbon is attacked by the negatively charged carbanion. So we know already carbanion is having a negative charge. This negatively charged carbanion is attacking on this positively charged carbon. So you can see it is forming a bond with this carbon, CH2CHO. Okay, this hydrogen I kept at downside. Okay, so now we know here there is a generation of negative charge on the oxygen. So this is called alkoxide ion. So in step 2, alkoxide ion is generated. Okay, I'm taking step 3. In step 3, same alkoxide ion I am taking, okay, to this alkoxide ion, to this I'm adding water. So this alkoxide ion, negatively charged oxygen, abstracts a proton from the water. Okay, it is abstracting a proton from the water and forming our desirable product, that is aldol. You can see here, O minus is abstracting H plus and forming OH bond. Okay, so this function, this particular compound, if you observe it, is consists of both OH and CHO functional groups. Hence, it is called aldol. Okay, al means aldehyde, OL means hydroxy group, that is alcohol group. Okay, so in this particular compound is consists of two functional groups and it is also called as 3-hydroxybutanol. So if I give the numbering 1, 2, 3. So third carbon is having OH, 3-hydroxy, and it is consists of four carbons, 1, 2, 3, 4. So it is called butanal. Okay, al means aldehyde. Okay, so this is about the mechanism of aldol condensation. You need to practice the steps, then only you'll remember the mechanism. Okay, thank you so much for watching.